standard technologies. So it will be very interesting get to know that what are the businesses that at TCS are involved in currently that business are doing worldwide or within India basis.
See, TCS is, if you see latest market capitalization, it's one of the largest market capitalization company, and it has top exporter of IT services. So if you look at TCS as a company, it employs more than 2,000 to 3,000 CMAs. So out of them, it is not just their core IT, core finance solutions, but it is to support their billing, I mean, the clients they have. So if they are supporting as a functional side of Oracle or functional side of any other ERP like SAP, they do come up with a team of CMAs and CAs and who are from top IT MBAs from top IT top IIMs or top B schools. So
if you talk about so the work, so what are the work that a CMA or finance involved with? If they are if some CMA after passing out the CMA, if they want to apply in TCS, so what will be the process that the CMA can get to learn? What are the process? Is there a different processes or what are the stuff that they can able to learn after joining TCS in terms of finance work?
So yeah, I'm coming to that point. So generally, once we qualify as a CMA, IT companies like either Accenture, TCS or Infosys, I worked in three of these companies, they have a similar pattern of hiring. So they go to CMA campus and they hire candidates, freshers, and they train on their ERP systems like of the candidate choice. So when I got an opportunity, I choose SAP or Oracle. So we have an option to select what is your interest area. And we can select what is our interest area, and then based on that, they will train us, and then we'll be put on billing. So instead of working for one single company, if we are in a billable resource as of supporting the finance roles, functional side, then we will be getting an opportunity to deal with multiple IT multiple companies, which are TCS clients, as an SAP Pico consultant or an Oracle financial consultant, any other ERP functional consultant. Then you can understand the entire finance structure of the organization. So that is a very good learning opportunity for us. And you are there to support all their finance activities in a simplified way. So once ERP system comes into place, the things will become much easier at the top level, and the overall control system will be much much more improved then. So
your work profile is related to SAP, right?
Yeah, SAP. And, we should. SAP.
And SAP is currently is very very much known term, and students and really wanted to know. So if somebody joined as a SAP consultant, so what will be the work of the SAP SAP consultant in TCS or in these kind of profiles?
So what will initially be the work of SAP? The minimum expectation from a SAP consultant, if you are a CMA, is that you should be able to match the business policies or business procedures into SAP system. So it's like we have a procedure in place which we do manually, or we do may have some other IT systems. If you take some example like a big company like Coca-Cola, you know, Apple, these kind of companies, they have vast operations, not just India, not just USA, but they have operations across the world. So there are multiple challenges that we have. There are multiple issues that there are multiple business areas that we have to understand. Then we have to apply our knowledge into matching their business processes. So basically, initially we have to identify what are the business requirements, and we have to map it into our ERP system, whatever our ERP system is. Well, it might be SAP, or some few clients may be taking part of Oracle, and it's both different, technically both are different ERP softwares, ERP package solutions, but still the work profile will be similar. So they will be having that, see, few organizations that you see as a PO, it will be there for more than 1 year also. There are few cases where one PO might drive for more than 1 year also. So we should be able to map these kind of scenarios into our ERP systems. And nowadays, everything is digitalized. So how the taxes should be calculated, how the invoices should be generated, how this consolidation should happen, everything will be driven by the ERP systems nowadays for large companies.
Nowadays, if you talk about these large companies, so all this taxation part and this analysis part is also converted into the digitalization process, right?
Exactly. So maybe, see, the analysis, so the systems can only give us the trends, the rates, and the business consultant or the business manager who are there, they have to take the final decision. So they should be able to get those information at the right point of time. So these IT systems that they're in the business space, they will help the business managers or the leaders to take correct decision at the correct point of time.
Okay, great. So student who are currently working must get to know about these or softwares also. Once they get into the IT, they cannot get only stuff with tally and all those stuff will no more. I think will be in work in coming future because ERP, Oracle, all these things going to take over.
Yeah, correct, Mithun. One thing is we should know is there is no small technology, there is no big technology like that. So if you have a MNCs like these companies which are multi-billion dollars or few are now multi-trillion dollar companies also there now. So they might afford ERP systems, but small companies or small organizations, they don't go with ERP systems. So we should initially should have some accounting package solution, knowledge like Tally or any other system. But we should also be able to understand these ERP systems so that we can get a better career opportunities. So there are few companies which gives only employment for who knows SAP at least as an end user. And if you commit to Infosys or TCS or Accenture, they majorly hire for consulting profile. They will also hire for core finance or core accounting roles, but it's very limited. So if you look at Infosys, it hires around more than 3,000 CMAs and CS together. And most of them are into billable roles. Billable here means they don't work for Infosys finance, but they work for clients' finance roles.
Okay.
So Infosys is partnered with Apple. I'm just giving you an example. So Apple it is a $2 trillion company, more than $2 trillion company now. So they will map their finance with their existing systems, and they do have existing systems. They have to map their business processes into the ERP. So they cannot have SAP licensed or Oracle licensed overall all accountant who are working across all countries.
Okay.
So they will
it's limited in Infosys for core finance profile.
So no, it's just I'm trying to explain that point itself. So they will have to map their. See, I'm in India. I work with Tally. So you are in some other country like UK. You work. You don't not much familiar with Tally, but SAP, but Oracle. But you have some other knowledge like FoxPro or some other tool. So the ERP system will have an ability to grab all the information between all the softwares and captured into SAP system or Oracle system. So it will be consolidated on a real-time basis and we'll get a clear picture. So you can't say at 5 a.m. India time, it might be 5 a.m. US time. You can't get a report, consolidated report at that point of time. So they will have a cutoff time, and based on that, they will get a report based on predefined timelines. And this consolidation will take at least 1 or 2 days time to get a proper time. So maybe if you are talking about January 31st month end report, if you need, you at least need to wait for February 3rd or 4th.
Okay.
And that is it, within 4 days, it is only possible because of we have powerful tools, IT systems in place now.
Yeah, the time span, working time span because of these tools are really get shorter because we can able to work more faster with a vast amount of work because of
exactly
these tools which are available. Yeah, correct. Thank you, Mandu, for sharing.